Because I respect you, I think you have the right to know the truth. I need you, though, to listen to me with your hearts as well as your ears. When you kids look at me today, you see an adult, an author, and a fairly successful one, but are you aware when you look at me, you're looking at a learning disabled student who grew up? If I were in your school today, I would be in special classes. Did you know that? Do you know I couldn't read till I was 14 years old? Couldn't do math, still have trouble with numbers, I've got to be honest. I couldn't write. I mean, can you imagine how I felt when I was your age? At your age, I made up my mind that I was dumb and stupid, pointless. I didn't even dare have any dreams. Why would I have any dreams? They're not going to come true. My nightmare was having to read in front of my class. Now, when I say in front, I'm not kidding. In my day, they made you get out of your seat, walk up to the front of the room, grab a book, open it, and then face all those kids. For me, this was like standing in front of a firing squad. The book would start shaking, my knees would buckle, my heart would pound so hard and so fast, I was sure the kids in the back row could actually hear it. I'd hang onto the book so tight it broke my fingernails. But do you know what I remember the most? Looking at them. They were looking at me, they were watching me, their eyes were looking at me, and inside I was thinking, oh God, please don't do this to me, don't make me do this, not in front of them, because now they're gonna know, they're all gonna know, they're gonna know how stupid I am. But I would try. It didn't matter how hard I try. My brain changes whatever I see. I have dyslexia, dysnumeria, dysgraphia, and another horror called failure of sensory integration. Now what that means is I could not hold still. I still can't. And at your age, that was a crime. When we were in school, you had to sit there like a rock. The thing of it is, if information is going in, I need to move. If you, right now, had something important you wanted to tell me, I will come near you, but I'm gonna look away from you. And while you're telling me, I start fidgeting with my hands, and I'll start rocking back and forth because I must move or whatever you are saying doesn't go in. Can you imagine how odd that looked to everybody else? So the kids started making fun of me. When I was through failing in front of my class and could put my book down and walk back to my seat, every single kid in that room started laughing. And they were laughing at me. And I was doing my best. I mean, now that I've grown up, I've come to realize I don't think those kids meant to be cruel. I think sometimes you young folks, when you see someone struggling, actually you're rather embarrassed for them. But you don't know how to handle your embarrassment, so you laugh. If you remember nothing I've said to you today, I am begging you to remember this one. Please don't laugh. You have no idea how much you're hurting that kid. Oh, they're gonna laugh right along with you and pretend it doesn't bother them. Oh yes, it does. That kind of cruelty goes into your soul and stays there pretty much for the rest of your life. Please don't.